We've been looking at the phrase in Genesis 1:2, formless and empty. The Hebrew, again, is tohu vabohu. And we've seen how that works in Genesis 1 and how that's the background to God's creating work in Genesis 1. We've seen how it works in the Mosaic order, where the work of setting up boundaries, of forming and filling, is delegated to human beings, to Moses overseeing the work of the building of the tabernacle. And then how that works in the prophetic literature, where the Israel sometimes collapses back into a formless and empty condition. And it might seem that that's fairly distant from concerns with everyday life, but I think it gives a great deal of insight into the importance of pastoral care within the church, and also some significant insight into the functioning of human cultures. The church is God's new creation in the earth. It's the new humanity. It's the new creation in kind of a nuclear form that's going to grow until it becomes, until it fills the whole earth. It's going to grow until Jesus comes and completes the work by bringing in the fullness of the new heavens and the new earth. But the church is already now that new creation. And as a new creation, it's bounded off and it functions and exists because it's formed and it has to maintain those boundaries. Pastoral care, in a lot of respects, is about boundary maintenance, and it's about the maintenance of the new creation that is the church. There are a lot of applications that we could think of in the contemporary world. Sexual issues come to mind immediately. When the church doesn't maintain the boundaries of sexual behavior, when sexual infidelity and sexual sin is tolerated in the church, that means that the form that the church has is being undermined, and it's turned into a chaos. It's turning into a shapeless mess. It's no different from the world outside. In order for the church to maintain itself as the new creation, it has to maintain these moral boundaries. And pastors in particular are charged with the task of maintaining those boundaries and enforcing those boundaries and encouraging and requiring people to live according to the commandments of God. And if they don't, then the world goes back into a kind of tohu vabohu, a kind of formlessness and emptiness. Cultures too depend on boundaries. Philip Reeve, a 20th century psychologist and sociologist, spoke about the primacy of prohibition in cultures. The thou shalt nots of culture are the thing that give it form. You can't have the primacy of possibility, where every kind of behavior is an open possibility. You have what Reeve called an anti-culture in that case. To have a culture, to have a common way of life, a bounded way of life, you have to have boundaries to human behavior. You have to tolerate certain behavior, and certain behavior has to be intolerable. We're living in a culture that's become, Reeve says, basically an anti-culture, with the primacy of possibility, with no boundaries. And as a result, we're living in a world that is very much like Genesis 1:2, formless and empty. It has no shape to it. Human behavior has no shape. And increasingly, we see it emptied out of people and of all the riches that we could enjoy under God's blessing. In order to restore culture, we have to restore the boundaries and maintain those boundaries so that it can function as a kind of sub-creation within God's creation.